diary. What a day I had today. I had to practice my triangle in the morning instead of the afternoon because Cousin Lamar called and it seems like
he's sick,
which is sad. But on the other hand, he asked me to drive his horse and buggy, which made me go completely mental with glee, I must say. Sheldon seemed very pleased. I remember it as if it were earlier this morning.
Which is not that surprising.
Cause it was like earlier this morning. Sheldon, look out!
Way too close.
Like, this is so sad. And at the final fortissimo, no less. Isn't that always the way?
Gee, I hope that didn't disturb your very peaceful morning, Moby.
Because mornings are so often very... Oh, now that's a pain that's going to linger. Gee, I wish you'd get over that. Oh, for heaven's sakes. Hi. Hi there. It's my neighbor, Miss Malone, returning from her morning stroll. Hi, up here. Miss Malone, it's me, Ed Grimley. Good seeing you. I see it's sweater weather.
Oh, hello, Eddie.
She called me Eddie. How decent is that? Give me a break.
She makes me go completely mental, I must say.
Hi, Mr. Grimley.
Oh, Wendell, how pleasant of you to drop by. Make yourself at home, Wendell, and try not to destroy anything today, okay? Just for fun.
Yeah, right. Hey, what's this? Wow, you still playing this whole thing? You should get one of these, Mr. Grimley. Just listen to this.
Why, thank you, Wendell.
My little friend with glasses. This should be...
Ouch! Gee, that was sad.
Hello, Eddie. Is my brother here?
Oh, Miss Malone, so good of you to drop by. Up. Won't you,
Come on, Tina, let's get going.
Oh, hello.
Wendell, come along. We're spending the day with Colonel Peabody, remember?
And I bought you some gum.
Oh, whoop-de-doo.
Miss Malone, I was wondering possibly,
as I'm driving my flu-stricken Cousin Lamar's horse and carriage today, if you'd like a ride through the park of your choice.
Oh, thanks, Eddie. Some other time, perhaps?
Well, sure. Certainly.
Come, Wendell. Bye, Eddie.
See ya, Grimley!
Is she not the best? I mean, give me a break. My heart is beating like a little distant jungle drum, I must say. Oh, look at the time. I suppose that would be decent, being late for Lamar's job. No way is my answer to that question. I mustn't forget this and this, yes. I suppose I'll just have to finish my triangle practice during my cup of soup break. There's no way around it. I wish there was.
Oh, would you just get moving?
Okay, then see you. Bye. Ah, attaboy. Come on, Leonard. Now we're moving. Very good, then. Leonard, somehow I don't think, and again, it's just a theory, that you're quite in the spirit of the thing. I mean, not to be critical, Leonard, because that would be sad, you know, but why the long face other than you have one?
Hey, you! Is this your cab?
Welcome to my little carriage, ma'am. I couldn't be more excited. Can I assume you've had lunch? Oh, good dog.
Well, let's get on with it.
No problem. Here we go. Just butt. That, oh, very good, then.
May we begin?
I'm sorry. Were you talking to me?
No.
Very well, Leonard. Let's proceed. Anytime now, Leonard. He's been, well, moody lately, so if just one second. Come on, horsey, my boy.
Oh,
please, Leonard, just let's...
Why? Where you want it?
Residential suite, 13th floor. Hey, careful, it's a heavy one.
Ha 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 ha.
If you ever felt like moving, please let it be now. No matter how you slice it,
we're as doom can be, you know.
Well, it looks like poor Ed is in sort of a spot of trouble, wouldn't you say, Roger?
Yes, he's about to be crushed like an itty-bitty bug.
And it's all thanks to gravity, which is our lesson today.
Splat!
Hello, my name is Amit.
And I'm Roger. We are the amazing Gustav brothers.
We tackle any topic,
immense
or microscopic, we dissect it and dissect it to discover what is true.
Principles we speculate,
theories we investigate,
analyze,
hypothesize,
and explain it all to you.
Here we are at 40,000 feet in the stratosphere. I mean, how can you not say we're very high up? We are.
And Emil is dressed like an apple to demonstrate Newton's discovery of gravity.
Sir Isaac Newton, wonderful English chap, born in 1642.
Emil will jump out of the aeroplane and plummet to Earth. Thereby reenacting the apple, which bopped Sir Isaac on the noggin. Of course, so as not to injure himself, Emil will be wearing this parachute. Not that one, stupid. The other one. Emil? Pilot, we may need to make an emergency landing.
This is gravity at work. I mean, how can you say it isn't? It is, in a way, to a degree, don't you think? For gravity is a force which causes material bodies to fall toward the center of the Earth. In other words, what goes up must go down. Resistance is one way of slowing down this remarkable process. For example, as they say in France, a city I've never been to, a country I don't even know. A parachute will allow me to gently drift toward the ground. Silly me.
Excuse me. Have you seen my brother, Emil? He's wearing a large red...
Let's review. Newton, like brother Roger, was struck on the head by a falling apple and thus discovered the law of gravity. Remember, science, like gravity, is an exciting adventure just waiting to be discovered.
Now, let's get back to Ed and see how gravity plays an important part in his life.
Come on, Leonard, time's a waste. Gee, that was possibly a hair too speedy for comfort. Amazing how music affected Leonard, don't you think?
Who do you think you are? Are you crazy? I'll have you know I'm the mayor of this city. And you'll never drive a carriage again.
Gee, that's sad.
Mr. Lamar Grimley.
Oh, this is just great. I suppose it could be worse. In 5 minutes, I totally destroy Cousin Lamar's future. Oh, and what will Uncle Balfour say? Has anyone thought about that? I can just forget all about Christmas dinner at their house now. Way to go. Oh, and I suppose it isn't fun playing Monopoly with Uncle Balfour and his friend. What was his name again? Oh, give me a break. This is insane. He was like the guy who owned Boardwalk and everything. I've heard of mood swings, but this is like a joke.
Taxi!
Leonard! Whoa! Is that the word? Yes.
Leonard!
Oh, give me a break!
Stop!
I'll say. Oh, great, not only do I destroy Lamar's carriage, but I still can't remember Uncle Balfour's friend's name. I want to say Harold, but I'm not quite sure that... 3 o'clock! Who knew? Time for Count Floyd. I hope I'm not too late.
It's time once again for Count Floyd's Scary Stories. Hi, kids. Welcome to my show.
All right, now, let's all hear the official Count Floyd Vampire Howl.
Oh, pardon me, kids. This damp weather, it's really got me coughing a lot.
Cough? What?
All right. Ooh, boy. Let me tell you something. We got a real scary story for you today. It's so scary that it's going to make those little hairs on the back of your neck just stand straight up so you look like a porcupine or some type of animal like that.
Mr. Floyd, can we just hear the story, please?
Count Floyd, all right? It's Count Floyd. You mind? Of course you can hear the story. Do I look like a Mr. Floyd in this outfit? All right. Ooh, you're going to be sorry you asked, because this is the most frightening story I've ever told. Oh, boy, you watch out for those hairs on your neck. Ooh, this one's called The Curse of the Headless Mummy. Ooh, boy. All right. Once upon a creepy time, there was a guy named Dr. Smythe, a famous archaeologist. Now, that's a guy who really digs his work. All right. Dr. Smythe, he was in Egypt excavating a lost but very spooky pyramid. Inside the forbidden temple were some hieroglyphics. Ooh, the doctor translated the ancient writings and read the message aloud.
He who enters this tomb shall never leave and be trapped for all of eternity.
Slowly crept along the creepy corridors, when all of a sudden, he heard a strange growling noise. Yes, it was the bandaged beast himself, the headless mummy.
Oh, boy. Isn't it scary to think what happened to that poor doctor when the mummy saw him?
If the mummy didn't have a head, how could he see?
Well, he couldn't see because he was a ghost-type mummy. That's why those ghosts, he could see everything around him because, you know, the ghosts are like that. Anyway.
But the mummy was going so slow. How come the doctor didn't just run?
Why? Because, see, he'd probably just eaten a big meal. And, you know, how his digestion was slowing him down real good. Besides, remember the curse. Ooh, that was a good curse, you know. He was trapped inside that pyramid for all eternity.
But if the mummy didn't have a head...
All right, enough with the questions, all right? We're finished with the question and answer time, okay? No more questions. All right. Ooh, the count's got to run. I've got to go sleep in my casket. Oh! The howl, kids. Get this group.
What a show. Floyd did it again. I would imagine that he would be a pretty decent guy to get to know.
Probably.
Leonard! Oh, Leonard! Leonard the horse! Len! Leonard? Geez, changed color and everything. That is... Oh, there's Leonard. Oh, well, now I understand.
Leonard's in love, I must say. Although she does have a bit of an attitude, no quest.
Leonard, get a hold of yourself. You're going mental.
I must say.
I mean, face it. You and she are from...
two different lands. Emotionally.
Wow. How pleasant. Maribel has company. Oh, well, that explains everything. Let's face it, Leonard. Maribel's attracted to racehorses.
Just too bad that you're not a ra-
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Listen, Leonard, this may sound mental, but I believe I have an idea. Come closer.
That's my little filly right down there.
How thrilling.
Let me see.
Huh?
Cool.
I can't breathe.
Come on. Hey, check it out. It's What's-His-Face.
What?
It is Eddie.
Hi there. How are you doing? Good seeing you.
Lovely day for a race, I must say.
I didn't know the little guy had it in him.
That makes me angry. That one horse has a head on.
I want Mr. Grimley's horse to win.
Hey, son, go buy yourself some peanuts and take your time.
Gee, 1,000.
Oh, Ms. Mayor, we weren't sure you were going to make it in time.
I wasn't either. Some fool, handsome cab driver almost killed me. But I fixed his wagon. I called City Hall and had his license revoked as of today. And if I ever see him again...
This should be a most pleasant outing, you know. Who's excited? Come on, Leonard, let's go. Anytime now, Eddie. And we're off.
He's gonna have to go a little faster than that if he wants to beat my Maribel.
Leonard, no offense, but I think you're taking that slow and steady wins the race thing just a hair too far.
Hey, Mr. Grimley!
Wendell!
How's it going?
Oh, why didn't I think of this sooner? I'd say don't go far, Leonard, but it hardly seems necessary.
Mr. Grimley, where are you going?
Hello, is this a Classics radio station? Yes, I'll hold. Yes, I'd like to request a song, please. Sure, I'll pledge. Uh-huh. Well, I'm in the book. Very good. Same to you. Yes. Could you please play a Hungarian Rhapsody number 7, also known as the Hungarian Love Rhapsody? Yes, and dedicate it to Leonard, his dear pal, Edward. Thanks so much. Bye-bye. Wendell, might I borrow your radio for a while?
It's yours, Ed Grimley. For 5 minutes!
What's the matter, Snookles? Yo!
What's that boy up to now?
This one goes out to Leonard from his pal Ed.
You did your best.
That's no lie.
Mr. Grimley!
The mayor!
I can't thank you enough for saving my little poopsie.
Well, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do, I must say.
As a reward, I plan to name you the official horse carriage driver for the city.
If that's not just the best, I think I'll go mental with joy, you know. Lamar will be so pleased. Oh, Leonard, is this not great when love is triumphant? This must be your luckiest of lucky days.
Eddie, I am so proud of you.
Love is grand. Or am I just a clown who's seen my nose?
So, diary, as you can see, it was quite a day. I'm still winded. Give me a break.
Miss Malone kissed me, which was pretty decent of her. Leonard and I are closer than ever. Of course, having a horse for a friend does entail certain problems as well. Okay, Leonard, I'll turn off the light in a minute. But tomorrow you're finding your own place, all right? You hear me, Leonard? Thank you.